Memories of Lucy always compete for space, so I write them. I think it's important to remember how you feel. Time goes by so fast, it's easy to neglect even the strongest emotions. Lucy and I split up 6 months ago. She sent me this letter. I read it then, but I can't remember what it said. I don't think I want to. My heartbreak has me by the balls. As the days go by, these fleeting memories fall through my fingers like sand. But I can't forget. I won't let them be replaced by clocks. Lucy's letter is different, though. I can't remember the words that were said, but the feeling stays familiar. One day, I'll read her letter again. One day, I'll remember what she said. Until then, I'll wait.
Hi.
Hi.
Is everything okay?
Yeah. I'm sorry. What was your name?
Allie, stop! Annie.
Like, Annie Hall. It's kind of cool.
So, is everything okay?
Oh, yeah, is that you? No. Never mind.
What?
Everything's fine.
Albie!
I'll see you later.
Okay. Sorry, what was
your... Charlie.
Oh.
Okay. See ya.
See ya.
Living for other people and not for myself. I keep having these dreams that I'm driving on this empty road at night with my headlights off. It feels like everything is paused for a bit, like I'm hiding from my life, like I could maybe, just for a second, feel like I'm starting over. There's something kind of nice about that.
Lucy used to love musicals. I could never really get into them. Split gave me a new perspective, though. I see it now. I like living in a dream. Memories of her still play in the back of my mind like a projector. It all seemed so important at the time, but I think I've gotten myself out. I lost Lucy. I lost what I loved. I found something new. Annie.
let's chase everyone from the place. Come on with the rain, I have a smile on my face.
Ink's running. Paper's tearing. Any moment, the letter will be unreadable. I don't want to, but now it's time to read it again. To remember what she said. Dear Charlie. It's not easy. I know it's been hard. Thank you for letting me go. I want you to know that even though we broke each other to pieces, there will always be a piece of you with me. And even though we'll always be in the periphery of each other's lives, it doesn't mean I can't root for you. I wish you could tell me how much you've changed. I wish you could tell me every detail about yourself. I wish it was easy to accept how things are. But it's not. And that's okay. Thank you for making me who I am. We both grew so much, and even though we can't be together anymore, I'm still grateful for it. For every moment we share. Wherever you are, however you're doing, I want you to know that no matter how much time passes, I'll never forget.
Just me for you and you for me alone. Nobody near us to see us or hear us. No friends or relations on weekend vacations. We won't have it known, dear, that we own a telephone.
good as I could possibly imagine my life getting, it did. After I met you, the way you reached inside my chest and pulled out things and sent them off in breaths blew. And as good as it got with all the layers peeling off, and though I writhed, I could not upset you. With your hand down my throat, you held on to my heart and pumped blood through. And then it's time to go, you said it's time to go out, you little gray goose. Get out from under my wing, you said you swan, go on, go out, you're turned loose. Oh, so it's over, oh, so we die. So your hand on my heart, pumping blood, went limp, and oh, I fight. Oh, swan inside.